Well, what you see behind me is the Futuro, and this is the prototype for the Futuro. It was built in 1968, and it was built as a vacation home for holidays, a mobile home. And the first idea started in 65 when the architect, Matti Suronen, a Finnish architect, was asked by a friend to develop a home that could be used for skiing. So it should be easy to use for sloping hills, and it should also, you must get it in pieces, easy to dismantle and to build up again. And Suronen started to think about several geometrical forms, and just by experimented he found the ellipse, and he thought, well, it's a nice form to use. And that was how it all started. It should also be a very cheap home and very, very light. And for that reason, polyester was chosen, which was a very new material at that time. And it is also a very revolutionary use of the material. And at that time, it was also quite cheap until 1973, when you got the oil crisis and suddenly the plastic industry became very expensive, and that was also the end of the Futuro. What you see here is the prototype, so it's the first model from which the other Futuros were developed, and we don't know how many exactly have been built, but the idea is around 50 to 100. It was meant to be a huge production so that everyone in the world would, for leisure times, would just be able to have a Futuro and put it somewhere when you would want it to be on vacation. At first in Finland it wasn't really a success, but then there was a huge exhibition in London, and then it suddenly became very popular, and then it was sold also to America, to Australia, New Zealand, Japan, and then it spread all around the world. Well, it was. You can see it as quite an icon of the 60s and the 70s, not only because of the use of the material, but also because it fitted very well into the idea of leisure at that moment, so that people would have to work less and less, and that everyone would have its own mobile home. And the shape is also very revolutionary, and for that reason it is still an inspiration for architects all around the world. And there has been several explicit uses of the Futuro. For instance, in Finland itself, it has been turned in a kind of dinner for a long time, but that wasn't liked by the architect at all, because it was really meant to be a home and not some kind of dinner. It was also bought by an artist in Düsseldorf, who put it on the roof of his own home and invited other artists like Andy Warhol to come there. So it quite soon became a sort of cult object for the jet set of that time, and also for architects. And the objects that we have put around here in this exhibition, especially this part from the 60s on, gives also an idea of the context in which the Futuro can be placed, as a sort of utopian idea which still has a lot of potential force. Well, the first one to trigger the Futuro was the German artist Carsten Höller, and he used it for an exhibition in Vienna, and that was the first time that the prototype, which was still owned by the architect, was exposed again. And from there on it was bought by the Centraal Museum in Utrecht, and they sold it to us in 2007 for the Museum Boijmans. And well, it has been used a lot, it has been exposed a lot, it has also been used as an office. And we saw that it really needed restoration, because otherwise it would completely tear down. And because it's a prototype, we also think it's different from the regular Futuros. It's the first one. It also has a slightly different interior. And for that reason, we restored it very carefully. So when you look at the skin of the Futuro, you see different kinds of blue. It all was very blue, but now you see yellow and you see tears and such things. And we just decided to keep it, not to turn it into something else, but also to keep the traces of time. And because we restored it very, how do you say, very carefully, it is not possible to expose it outside again, because you have where the different parts are put together. When it rains or when there's wind, it all gets into the interior, so it's damaged very easily. If you would have done something to it, you really would have to cover to make a new shell, and we didn't want to do it because of the prototype character. Well, we will expose it here for this exhibition, and then we have the submarine wharf where there's a huge exhibition opened tomorrow on Elmgreen and Dragstad. And after that exhibition, the Futuro will go there, because it doesn't need a really museum environment, but it needs protection from wind and water. And that's a huge hall, and I think it will look very nicely there.
Thank you.